MH17 went down almost 6 years ago, and today, after a marathon search for answers, a trial into the disaster begins in the Netherlands.
6 years. But the four men who've been charged likely won't ever appear. Paul Gard lost his parents, Jill and Roger, in the tragedy, and he joins us now. Paul, thank you so much for your time this morning. What are you hoping will come out of this trial?
Well, personally, I've always blamed the conflict itself for the tragedy, but so the trial's not going to fix that or solve that conflict. But I do think the useful things coming out of it will be to put a focus on why and how Russia was involved in this conflict and exactly who was responsible and why we haven't got an apology and an acknowledgement of responsibility. Yeah.
And how do you feel that this is, you know, as we're saying, it's been nearly 6 years now. In that time, no one has been held accountable, no one has said sorry. Does it feel like this is never ending?
Well, as I say, I've always blamed the conflict, so I suppose for me, I'd prefer the focus to be on resolving that conflict. And there's also still the issue of people flying over conflict zones not being safe, so we've seen in January a Ukrainian jet shot down in Iran, mainly because of higher tensions and inflamed rhetoric from world leaders. So I'd like to see those conflicts resolved and more focus put on avoiding those conflicts happening.
Paul, I'm very sorry, I'm 6 years on, but I'm still incredibly sorry for your loss and what you've been through. Trauma is of that nature is incredibly difficult, trauma of any nature is. But would an apology... Would an apology be enough for you if Russia came out and said, you know what, we were responsible for that? Because I know a lot of the other family members have gone, I just want someone to say sorry and take responsibility for what they did.
Well, I think that would help a lot. A lot of families would appreciate that. And it's been too long, obviously, but I think if there was an acknowledgement that it wasn't intentional and that it was a function of a terrible war going on, then at least that's something where families
can start to
take some solace. Well, there's not much chance of it, but maybe in a future world where you know, Russia's had a change of government or something like that, maybe there'll be a re-examination of what actually happened.
Now, the families have all been told they can read a victim impact statement. Is that something that you're considering?
Yeah, we've thought about that, and it may well be that we travel over there to do that, but we haven't made a decision on it.
Is there anything you would like to say this morning?
Well, I do think that it's good that they're holding some of the fairly senior people in the separatist army and the Russian military to account in this trial. So I'm glad that they've gone after the higher people in the hierarchy. So hopefully, if anything good comes out of it, it might cause a few people in those sort of situations to think twice about getting involved in these sort of conflicts if they're going to be prosecuted in an international court. But we'll see. We'll see if anything good comes out of it. Hopefully, there will.
All right, Paul. I mean, we know it's going to be a very long trial. Thanks for your time this morning. We really appreciate it.